And this is an A8 W12. The Touareg is probably flooring it. I like that. It's quite subtle. Tunnel. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we've got another viewer's car, because this is Costa's Audi S8 D4. It has been tuned, it has some cool stuff on it. So today I'm going to show you around it, show you all the cool stuff on it, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for an Autobahn blast. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video. And check us out on Instagram if you like, at Autotop.nl. Alrighty, so Costas has been a viewer of ours ever since we started in 2010. And well, that is just something I wanted to mention, because that is super, super cool. So Costas, thank you so much for joining us and sticking with us through all these years. And well, it's an honor for me to review your car. So that is what we're going to do right now. Now, it is not stock, as I said, but we'll start with the outside, because he has gone for this absolutely gorgeous blue wrap. Dark blue with a metallic flake in there. And when the sun hits it, you can actually see those metallic flakes. It's a really, really good wrap. And I really like this spec and this color combination on the S8, because we also have this like bronze colored splitter here, a little splitter, and all the rest is blacked out apart from the mirrors, which are still in that S aluminium look, which is really nice. He has coated these daytime running lights to be orange, which I also really like. Looks cool. And this is an A8 W12 grille, which is also pretty nice, because it has these little gratings behind the bars. I think it looks really cool. It looks just a little bit different from a regular S8, and that's cool, because you wouldn't notice it unless you've been told, and when you see it, it looks cool. I like that. It's quite subtle. The wheels, a bit less subtle, of course. 21-inch Vossen wheels. These are actually custom made by Vossen to fit this car, because it has to fit these Audi ceramic brakes. So 275s at the front, which is pretty massive. And again, that color matches this little splitter, that bronze goldish, which is pretty nice. The wheels do fit nicely on the car, I would say. I mean, it has that bit of a tuned look, but it is a beautiful wheel. And at the rear, we've got also 275s, 21-inch, with Pilosport 4S tires. These are actually the acoustic tires, so the acoustic 4S's with the foam, so they are a little bit more silent compared to the regular ones. We've got a Miltec non-resonated exhaust, and as you will hear in a minute, this is actually perfect. This exhaust just brings the car alive, brings the sound alive. It is quite a bit louder than stock, but it's not annoying. So he has not gone for a decat downpipe. And here we have the 4-liter V8 bi-turbo engine, the TFSI. And I'm going to remove the cover so you guys can see that he has changed the turbos. These are actually a bit bigger than stock. We've got a stock manifold, and then we've got Red Star heat shielded downpipes with 200 cell catalytic converters in there. So he didn't go for the decat, luckily, because that's just way too loud, too resonating, too smelly as well, which doesn't fit an S8, I would say. So stock 520 horsepower, 650 newton meters of torque. With this setup, you know, it has all this stuff plus an ECU remap, of course, brings the total to around 750 horsepower and 1000 newton meters. So that is a really, really nice setup. Now, the limitation for this engine, which is the case with the RS6 as well, is the fact that it has a liquid cooled cooling system. So the car runs, or the engine runs, quite hot, and you have to really cool it down to be able to extract the max from it. So it's quite a bad system, really. And that's also a shame if you go and tune it, you know, that's part of the limitation of this car. Now, in here, we have a beautiful spec, I have to say, with the carbon, with all the aluminium. He actually has the rear seat entertainment as well, which is quite rare in an S8, apparently. And the center console in the rear with the carbon as well. It does look really, really nice. It's such a nice car, so comfortable, so beautiful. We've got the most beautiful Audi dials ever with those angled analog ones and the digital screen in the center. I really love those, my favorite. And when we start it up, you can hear that it is quite a bit louder than stock, I would say. Yeah, it is in dynamic mode. And very cool, he has programmed these gauges in here in the MMI system. So you have exhaust temperature, turbo boost, and intake temperature. Now this is important because you have to keep that relatively cool, as I said, because otherwise if this gets too hot, you will lose performance and you have to cool it down. So a couple of revs. That sounds really, really, really good. I really like that because it fits the character of an S8. It's like, it sounds like a V8, but it's not like in your face. It's not, no pops and bangs, none of that nonsense. It's just a nice sounding V8. And it is quite a bit louder than stock, of course, so. All right. So, driving it, well, there's one thing that I notice immediately when driving it. Those front tires are probably a little bit too wide, or those front wheels. So if you have like tracks in the road from trucks, the car will follow them really, really aggressively. The steering is also quite heavy because of those wider front tires. And the balance of the front axle is, well, it's not like it should be. So if you turn into a corner like this one, you turn in, everything seems fine. It's a little bit wobbly, but of course it's an S8, so it can be. But after that initial like set, it starts shifting, moving around a little bit. It's really weird. So I do think that if you would put some stock wheels on this car, that would disappear and it would feel a little bit more balanced. The wheels do look cool, but you know, it's up to Kostas in this case to decide whether he, you know, wants the cool look and have this be a little bit worse than stock, or have the stock wheels and have the car look a bit, you know, normal. Tunnel. That is loud, especially that upshift bang is really, really loud. I really like that. It is such a good sound. It's actually perfect. I wouldn't change anything about that sound. Right on the money. Okay. So the power is very nice. You can feel that it is so aggressive, and it has that really, that quintessential, well, it's become quintessential now because we have driven so many cars with a tuned version of this engine. It does need some time to build, but when it does, it absolutely flies and it runs through the rev range so quickly. It is a really nice engine to tune because it's so rewarding. All right, so here we go at the Autobahn. We've got a digital speedo right there in the center, right there. And well, let's see what this car feels like at the Autobahn. So we'll give that Touareg a little bit of space so he can play around with his car as well. And I think that van is going to overtake. Yes, there he goes. It's quite empty behind us. Temperature 35 degrees, should be fine. Here we go. Full throttle. you can see the temperature going up quite quickly. But this power delivery, very, very smooth, quite powerful. Car sits quite nicely on the road. I think that was 298. Had to brake for these guys, but that is quite nice actually. That went to 300 pretty quickly and pretty easily. Okay, so now the temperature goes down again. The Touareg is probably flooring it. Oh, so performance wise, 100 to 200, we measured a 7.17 run. It could be quicker. I think Kostas did record some quicker runs. And well, 100 to 200, 750 horsepower, 7.17 seconds. That checks out. That should be right. You just see that from 0 to 250 kilometers an hour, it sort of loses that lead over other cars. And that's when you can see that cooling problem that this car has. If you run at higher speeds, full throttle for a longer period of time, you can see that it just gets hot and is less able to deliver that performance. So the next step, Kostas told us, is he is going to Clarkson Motors, which is, you know, the best with these engines, I would say. And the next step would be a water methanol injection system to get that charge cooling, or to get that temperature down and improve the charge cooling. So that should be pretty cool. I mean, we're definitely going to drive it after Kostas takes it to Clarkson Motors. So temperatures are a-okay. It's a beautiful day today as well, because we've got that sun to heat up the tarmac and we've got the cool air to feed into the engine. But this basically is the perfect Audi S8 tune. It's not too crazy, but it does sound really, really good and it goes really, really well. There is still some more potential in here. Kostas told us himself that he does want to go to the next level. So, man, that is going to be even cooler. But this is already so effortless. Absolutely love these S8s. So freaking easy. What a car. Great job, Kostas. I really, really like it. Just those front wheels. I would just check that out. See if you can fit a stock set on there and see what the difference is, because it feels a little bit weird. But other than that, power, spec, I really love the subtle dark blue color. It's a really, really cool car. Thank you so much for bringing it to us. To you guys, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right there. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye.